Hey everybody, Hunter with Injected Motorsports. We're going to show you our Bushwacker Fender Flare install on the LBZ. Just kind of show you a couple of tips, tricks, what we found. I have a write-up on it. Just a little video that goes with it, and we'll kind of show, you know, everything that's different on it.
All right, we'll start here at the front passenger side. Like I said, these turned out really well. They use titanium rivets. The product is nice and sturdy. The finish is nice. I've already taken this off a couple times, off-road that is. So that's why you have see some kind of rocks being thrown at it already. On this front one, like I was stating in the description right here, we had to drill this one out. We tried the 5/16, it was way too big for these pop style retainers. So that's why we put a different style in. It still held just fine, but that's why that one's different. I'm coming back here. These are the little retainer screw rivets. I didn't really care for them, but they're not too bad. You just gotta be really careful and not twist that head off. Like I left this one in to show you, like we did here. If you twist it just a little bit too hard, it will pop off. But yeah, as far as that goes, everything up went up pretty easily. You have to make sure your rubber here is sitting tight. You'll actually see the indentions right here. That's how you line it up to the cab right here. It's nice and flush. Yeah, moving to the back. Here's the back passenger. Here we did not actually drill anything. We never had to drill any of these. They went on. This one went on nice. Went on perfect. This one was very, very easy. All the holes matched up. You can see a nice tight fit there. Move along to the driver's side. This one was a little bit more difficult. We actually had to drill the top two, this one and this one. We started at the back here, but these actually went in nicely. But it actually takes two people really, because you really have to press and hold this against it while you try to screw these in. But once that's in, like I said, they fit up real nice. And everything's nice and flush. And then the front driver was a little bit of a booger. Here we had to, this one fit nicely up front. This one here, we had to drill this one, and we had to drill this one again, the top two. The back, it fit, but the problem with the back, as you can see on this previous owner, you can see right down here, they did that NorCal fender mod, cut the lining a little bit. And when you beat that panel back, this screw here sits away too far from the edge, so it's hard to get that pop style rivet in. What we're gonna have to do on this one, as you can see, there's a gap right here. It's a little bit loose. So what we'll have to do is we'll probably just put a stainless self-tapper under there just to hold it tight. But just a note, if you have that fender mod and it doesn't fit just quite right, that's probably why. But everything else, as you can see, fit up really nice. That's pretty much it. Typically, if you don't run into any issues, this should be about 45 minutes to an hour long install. Pretty simple. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, just give us a shout. Thanks.